Today we shall discuss on discrete probability distribution. In this section, we shall discuss of some of the probability distribution that figure most prominently in statistical theory and applications. We shall also study their parameter, derivation of their some important characteristics. We shall also introduce number of discrete probability distributions that may have been successfully applied in wide variety of decision situations, especially in engineering applications. The purpose of this section is to show the type of the situations in which the distributions can be applied. This section devoted to a study of univariate distribution. Univariate means a single variable distributions, and like discrete uniform distribution or discrete rectangular distribution, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, geometric distribution and hypergeometric distribution. In the previous section we have already defined distribution function, mathematical expectation, variance and moment generating function of random variable in the both the cases, discrete as well as continuous case. This prepares us for a study of discrete theoretical probability distribution. Now, the first distribution in case of discrete random variable, discrete uniform distribution. In this, the word discrete represents the numbers or random variable is discrete, not continuous. Discrete means finite number or a countably finite number. And uniform represents their probability that remains same in each case. If x equal to 1, x equal to 2, x equal to 3 and so on. In that case, for every value of x, probability remains same or equally likely cases of the random variables. Such distribution known as discrete uniform distribution. And the definition or mathematical definition of discrete uniform distribution is a random variable x said to have a discrete uniform or rectangular distribution over the range 1 to n. If its probability mass function is given by probability of x equal to x is equal to 1 by n for the value of x is equal to 1, 2, 3 up to n value and otherwise 0. Remaining values of x, the probability of x equal to x is equal to 0. So in each case for x equal to 1, 2, 3 or any value between 1 to n, probability of that value is always remains same and which is equal to 1 by n. Here n is known as a parameter of the distribution that lie in the set of all positive integers. Mean of and variance of discrete random variable of particular case discrete uniform distribution. We shall use basic definition of mean and variance. Here mean is equal to expected value of a random variable x, and in discrete case it is equal to summation varies over x equal to 0 to n x into probability of x equal to x. And in case of discrete random variable, probability of x equal to x or probability mass function is given by 1 by n, where n is constant value. So 1 by n outside the summation sign, and we get x equal to 0 to n x. And if we expand the summation, we get 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n. So here, sum of first n natural numbers and whose sum is given by n into n plus 1 divided by 2. And the required result is n plus 1 by 2. So the mean of discrete uniform distribution is equal to n plus 1 by 2. Similarly, we can find variance of discrete uniform distribution and variance of discrete uniform distribution, variance of x equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So in this case first we find expectation of x square. Expectation of x square is equal to summation over the x equal to 0 to n x square probability mass function for given random variable. So x equal to 0 to n summation x square as it is, probability of x equal to x is 1 by n in case of discrete uniform distribution. So 1 by n summation varying from x equal to, sorry, x equal to 1 to n x square. If we expand the summation, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus up to n square. So here, square of sum of first n natural numbers, square sum of first n natural numbers is n plus 1, 2n plus 1, n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. So n cancel by n and we get n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6, which is expectation of x square. Therefore, variance of discrete uniform distribution x is equal to n plus 1 in place of expectation of x square, 2n plus 1 divided by 6 minus n plus 1 divided by 2 whole square, which is expectation of x square. In this case, n plus 1 is a constant value. So 2n plus 1 divided by 6 minus n plus 1 divided by 4. N plus 1, and in this case we get by the LCM 4n plus 2 minus 3 into n plus 1 divided by 12. This is LCM of 6 and 4. N plus 1, after the simplification we get n minus 1 in numerator divided by 12. So resultant result is n plus 1 into n minus 1 divided by 12. So these are two characteristics of uniform distribution, discrete uniform distribution, which is mean is equal to n plus 1 by 2 and variance equal to n plus 1 into n minus 1 divided by 12. The example of discrete uniform distribution is well known example, which is the number of points obtained on a single throw of unbiased die for a uniform distribution. Because in this case, random variable x would assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 values, and probability of x equal to x, any number on the top is equal to equal. So 1 by 6, 1 by 6, 1 by 6, 1 by 6 and 1 by 6. Equally likely cases. So such example represent a discrete uniform distribution with probability mass function. In this case, probability of x equal to x, any number, is equal to 1 by 6 for the value of x equal to 1 to n and 0 otherwise. Now mean of the this discrete uniform distribution, expectation of x is equal to n plus 1 by 2, which is n equal to 6 plus 1 divided by 2, which is 7 by 2, and its resultant value is 3.5. so average in this case of infinite repetition of this example is 3.5, and variance of this distribution is equal to n plus 1 n minus 1 divided by 2 divided by 12. Here n equal to 6, so n plus 1 7 into 6 divided by 7 into 5. N plus 1 6 plus 1 and 6 minus 1 divided by 12. So 35 by 12 is variance in this case. Now the next important distribution in case of discrete and discrete probability distribution, which is binomial distribution. And binomial distribution, in this case, binomial means two terms. If we separate the experiment or the outcomes of an experiment into two different event, first one is success and no mapping of that event into failure, then such distribution known as binomial distribution. Let a random variable be performed repeatedly and let the occurrence of the event in a trial be called success and its non-occurrence called a failure. Consider a set of n independent trials in which probability of success in any trial is constant for each trial. Then Q equal to 1 minus P is the probability of failure in any trial. So if we in this condition, so if we consider there are n independent Bernoulli trials and if R successes occurs, if R successes occurs, then there will be n minus R failures. And one of the event of such cases, success, failure, success, failure and failure, success, failures in this case. So probability of such event, success, F represent failure. Because of events are independent, trial is independent Bernoulli trials, so probability of success into probability of success into probability of failure, probability of failure, probability of success, probability of failure. Now probability of success remain constant in each trial and which is equal to P. So P into P, probability of failure Q, and Q into P into Q. If we rearrange this, we get P into P into P or Q into Q into Q up to N minus R. So success are R times and failures are N minus R times. So P raised to the power R and Q raised to the power N minus R in this case. But R successes out of N independent trials come in NCR ways. R successes in N trials come into or arrange in NCR ways. So probability of R successes means probability of X equal to R successes is equal to NCR P raised to the power R Q raised to the power N minus R in this case. And therefore the mathematical definition comes through this derivation is if a random variable X set to follow binomial distribution, if its assume only non-negative values and its probability mass function is given by probability of x equal to x success is equal to ncx, where ncx represent combination number of arrangement of x values out of n value p raised to the power x, q raised to the power n minus x for the values of x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n, and otherwise the probability of x equal to 0. So two independent constants n and p in the distribution are known as parameters of the distribution. N is also sometimes known as the degree of the binomial distribution. We shall use the notation symbolically we present x is a binomial gradient with the parameters n and p, where n represents number of trials and p represents probability of success in each cases or in each trials. Now the physical condition for the binomial distribution, the first one is each of trials result in two mutually disjoint outcomes termed as success or failure. Occurrence of any event known as success and non-occurrence of that event is a failure. The number of trials, secondly, the number of trials n is finite. In this case, the trials are independent of each other. In third case, the trials are independent. And in the last condition, the probability of success P is constant for each trial. That means probability remains constant in each trial. Now, the mean and variance, two important characteristics of binomial distribution, which is mean equal to expected value of x, and by the basic definition of expectation of x, which is equal to summation of x, b with probability mass function of x over the range x equal to 0 to n. So in this case, summation over x equal to 0 to n, x as it is, probability mass function in case of binomial distribution is ncx p to the power x q to the power n minus x. X equal to 0 to n, now ncx represent combination of x value out of n values. So by the formula factorial n, x factorial n minus x factorial, probability of x q raised to the power n minus x, x equal to 0 to n, we remove this x in the numerator and for this expand the factorial notation. So x into x minus 1 factorial n minus x factorial as it is, and n into n minus 1 factorial, factorial n converted into n minus 1 factorial p to the power x q to the power n minus 1 n minus x as it is. Now x cancelled by this x and outside the summation sign, because independent of the values x and 1 p remove from this p to the power x. So if 1 p outside the summation sign, we get x equal to 1 to n, n minus 1 factorial, x minus 1 factorial and n minus x factorial as it is. Here p raised to the power of x minus 1, q raised to the power n minus x as it is, which is again definition of binomial distribution, where total cases or total trials we should be n minus 1 and in which x minus 1 are successes. So by the binomial expansion q plus p whole raised to the power n, and probability of success remain constant in each trial, so q plus p and q equal to 1 minus p, so p plus q equal to 1 in this case, and so q plus p whole raised to the power n is equal to 1 raised to the power n, which is equal to 1, and hence the mean of the binomial distribution is number of trial into probability of success. Now the variance of binomial distribution, variance of x by definition, expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square root square of mean. So first we find expectation of x square, expectation of x known, which is equal to mp, expectation of x square. First we convert x square into x, x minus 1 plus x, x into, sorry, expectation of x into x minus 1 plus expectation of x, which is equal to np. Now we find expectation of x into x minus x minus 1, summation over x equal to 0 to n, x x minus 1 as it is, probability mass function for x equal to x. So in this case summation varies from 0 to n, x minus 1 into x as it is, probability mass function for binomial distribution ncx p to the power x q to the power n minus x, summation over x equal to 0 to n, x into x minus 1 as it is, ncx equal to factorial n, x factorial n minus x factorial p to the power x as it is, and q to the power x n minus x as it is. We simplify in this way, where q plus convert into a binomial expansion and then find the resultant value. So first we extend the factorial x into x, x minus 1 outside the factorial notation, and then we get x minus 2 factorial. So if we replace this one, this x into x minus 1 cancelled by this, and we get now x start from x equal to 2 to n, from n factorial
we spread into n into n minus 1 and n minus 2 factorial as it is in the denominator, x minus 2 factorial and n minus x factorial as it is. Now p to the power x converted into p to the power x minus 2 because of here now success remaining x minus 2. So p square outside the bin. Q raised to the power n minus x as it is. So now we get summation over x equal to 2 to n p square n into n minus 1 outside the summation notation and factorial n minus 2 factorial x minus 2 into factorial n minus x represent n minus 2 c x minus 2 probability of success p raised to the power x minus 2 and q raised to the power n minus x is represented by the binomial expansion q plus p whole raised to the power n minus 2 and this is equal to p square n n plus 1 q plus p equal to 1 so n minus 1 is this one. So n square p square minus n p square and therefore expectation of x square is equal to expectation of x into x minus 1 which is n square p square minus n p square plus expectation of x which is n p n square p square is it in this last two terms n p is common remaining value 1 minus p which is equal to q. So n square p square plus n p q is the resultant value of expectation of x square and therefore variance of x in case of binomial distribution is equal to expectation of x square which is n square p square plus n p q minus expectation of x square of mean which is n square p square and therefore variance of binomial distribution is equal to n p q. Multiplication of number of trial, probability of success and probability of failure. And in this case, expectation of x equal to np and variance of x equal to np. Q is always less than equal to 1. So, variance is always less than the mean. And in the binomial distribution, mean is always greater than variance. Now the next distribution in case of discrete random variable is Poisson distribution. Poisson is a mathematician, French mathematician. He discovered the Poisson distribution and Poisson distribution is a distribution related to probabilities of the events which are extremely rare but which have a large number of the independent opportunities for the occurrence. The following cases are instance where Poisson distribution may be successfully employed. First one is the number of the deaths from a disease such as heart attack or cancer or due to a standby. Second example, the number of suicides reported in a particular rare event. In case of third example, the number of defective materials being manufactured by a good concern. If a good concern, then there will be a defective materials, number of defective materials may be a rare event or in negligible cases. The number of faulty plates in a packet of 100. The next example is number of air accidents in some unit of time, which is rare event because of number of accidents is rare in case of general case. The number of printing mistakes at each page of the book, which is also an example of Poisson distribution because in this case x represents mistakes at per page of the books and which is a negligible events. The number of car passing a crossings per minute during the busy hours of the day. So all these examples represent Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is also a limiting case of the binomial distribution under the following condition. In the binomial distribution, number of trials remain finite, but in case of Poisson distribution, number of trials tends to an indefinitely large value. So the first condition is the number of trials is indefinitely large. This means n tends to infinity in this case. The second condition in which the binomial distribution goes to a Poisson distribution in this limited case, t is the constant of the probability of success for each trial is indefinitely small. That is, p tends to 0, or p tends to 0 means approximately 0, not equal to 0 in this case. And third, the number of trial and probability of success remains constant, and which is equal to a lambda or any constant value lambda, and always greater than equal to 0, because of n is always number of times positive value, p is always lies between 0 to 1, so both the values are positive, so their multiplication is also a positive real numbers. So if n tends to infinity and probability of success in each trial is indefinitely small, then binomial distribution goes to a Poisson distribution in this case. Now the definition of Poisson distribution. A random variable x said to follow Poisson distribution if it assumes non-negative values and its probability mass function is given by probability of x equal to x successes is equal to exponential of minus lambda. Exponential of minus lambda into lambda raised to the power x divided by x factorial, where x varies from 0, 1, 2, 0 to infinity, and lambda is always greater than 0 and a real number. Here lambda represents parameter of the Poisson distribution, and which is equal to n into p. We shall use the notation, or symbolically x is a Poisson variable, t represents Poisson with parameter lambda. Now, mean and variance of the Poisson distribution, these are two characteristics of Poisson distribution, is it? Mean equal to expected value of x. And if we apply limiting case of the binomial distribution, then limit n tends to infinity and np equal to lambda, in that case, then expectation of x of binomial distribution tends to mean of or expected value of Poisson distribution. So limit n tends to infinity np equal to lambda, and expectation of x in case of binomial distribution is equal to np. Now np equal to lambda, a constant value which is greater than 0, so as n tends to infinity, np equal to lambda, then lambda tends to a constant value. So the mean of the Poisson distribution through a limiting case of binomial distribution is equal to lambda. Similarly for variance of x, variance of x represent variance of binomial distribution, variance of Poisson distribution is equal to limit as n tends to infinity and np equal to lambda, variance of Poisson variance of binomial distribution. In this case, limit n tends to infinity and p equal to lambda, and in that case, now variance of binomial distribution is np cube, which we find in the earlier condition. Now np equal to lambda in this case, so as n tends to infinity and p equal to lambda, q equal to 1 minus p, and also p tends to 0 in this case. There is one more condition included in this condition, p tends to 0. So n tends to infinity and p tends to 0, if we put p equal to 0, we get lambda. So mean and variance remain same in case of Poisson distribution, and which is equal to lambda. In binomial distribution, mean is always greater than variance. In Poisson distribution, mean is always equal to variance of Poisson distribution. distribution. Now the next discrete probability distribution, theoretical probability distribution, which is geometric distribution. Suppose we have a series of independent pairs, repetition, and on each repetition or trial, the probability of success remains the same. This case has same but a particular type of binomial distribution. Suppose the series of independent trials or repetitions, and on each repetition or trial, the probability of success remains same, which is equal to p. Then the probability that x failure preceding the first success is given by q raised to the power x into p. Because in this case, x can assume 0 failure preceding the first success, 1 failure preceding the first success, 2, and so on. So, x failure preceding the first success represent q raised to the power x into p. And the mathematical definition of geometric distribution is a random variable x said to have a geometric distribution if its assumed non-negative value and its probability mass function is given by probability of x equal to x, which means probability of x failure preceding the first success is equal to q raised to the power x into p, which show probability of success, where x varies from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinity, p is greater than or equal to, p is greater than 0 and less than 1, and q is also equal to 1 minus p, and 0 in case of remaining values of other than x, which is negative or outside the given range. Since various probabilities for x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on are the various term of geometric progression, because in this case, if x equal to 0 success preceding the first success, or 1 failure preceding the first success represent q into p, 2 failure preceding the first success q square p, 3 failures preceding the first success q cube p, and so on, which represent geometric progression. The various terms of geometry p into qp, q square p, q cube p, the common difference between two successive terms remains same in the first and second and first term q, third and second term q. So this term represents as a geometric progression and hence the name geometric distribution. Clearly, the assignment of probability is permissible. Assignment of probability in this probability distribution is permission because of when x vary from 0 to infinity. Total sum of this probability qxp equal to, expand the summation, x equal to 0 in this case, p plus qp plus q square p plus and so on. Here p is common value, 1 plus q square plus and so on, which is a geometric progression. And sum of infinite time of geometric progression is equal to a, which represents a means first term of the series divided by 1 minus r. R represents common ratio between two successive terms. So ratio of second and first term is q. So p into 1 minus q equal to p equal to 1, and therefore this function represents the probability mass function. Now mean and variance of geometric distribution. By the definition, mean equal to expectation of x, and expectation of in case of discrete random variable, summation over the x equal to 0 to infinity, x into probability mass function. So x equal to 0 to infinity, x as it is, probability mass function in case of geometric distribution, q raised to the power x into p. If we expand the expansion, x equal to 0, first term becomes 0, 1, x equal to 1 into qp plus 2 into q square p plus n into q raised to the power np plus n, so p is constant, q plus 2q square plus 3qq plus n, So in the bracket, the series is not a geometric series, nor a arithmetic series. This series is like a arithmetic geometric series. So the first term, 1, 2, 3, represent the arithmetic series or arithmetic progression, and second term of this of every term is q, q square, q cube, represent a geometric series. Here q is also common. So p into q, 1 plus 2q plus 3q square plus n, so on. So first we find the sum of arithmetic geometric series and then find the mean of the geometric distribution. So let s equal to 1 plus 2q plus 3q square plus n, so on. We multiply this sum is equal to by the common ratio. So q into s equal to q, and then here from second term q plus 2q square plus n, so on. So in this case we get, if we subtract this one, s common, 1 minus q equal to 1 plus q square plus n, so on, which is geometric progression with common ratio q, and sum of infinite GP is equal to 1 upon 1 minus r. So expectation of x or mean equal to expectation of x, which is equal to here pq common in the previous case, and s equal to 1 upon 1 minus q square, because here s into 1 minus q equal to 1 minus q. This implies that s equal to 1 upon 1 minus q whole square, which is equal to 1 upon p square. So pq and 1 minus q equal to p, so p square, you know, cancel by p, and we get q by p. So mean of the geometric distribution is equal to q by p. This is a basic definition of expected value of x. In this case, probability mass function is qx, q raised to the power x into p, and then after simplification we get q by p as a mean of geometric distribution. And similarly, we can find variance of geometric distribution, which is equal to q by p square. The last discrete theoretical probability distribution, which is hypergeometric distribution, a particular case of probability distribution of simple probability distribution. If x represents the number of defective forms when n items are drawn without replacement from a load of capital N items, which means in a load of capital N items where k items are defective and n minus k are not defective, we select or we throw n items out of which r are defective, therefore n minus r are not defective. So selection of r defective from k defective items and n minus r not defective from n minus k. So in this case, probability of x equal to r is equal to KCR, selection R defective out of K defective items and N minus R defective non-defective item from N minus, and total selection out of N is NCN, and which is known as hypergeometric distribution because of various terms for value of r equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 to minimum of n and k represent the terms of hypergeometric series. So this is a simple case of probability, and mathematical definition of this distribution is, if x is a discrete random variable that can assume non-negative values 0, 1, 2, 3 up to minimum of n and k, if its probability mass function is given by probability of x equal to r is equal to selecting r defective item out of k item and selecting m minus r non defective from n minus k remaining item without replacement out of total n items, where r equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus k. X follows geometric hypergeometric distribution with the parameter capital N, k and small n. Clearly, assignment of the probability in this probability distribution case of hypergeometric distribution is permissible, which means the total sum of the probability is always equal to 1, which is the essential condition for a function is a probability mass function. So, x equal to 0 to infinity kcr n minus k c n minus r divided by capital N c n. In this case, n c n is a constant value, so 1 upon n c n outside the summation, x vary from 0 to infinity in this case, kcr n minus k c n minus r. Now, summation x equal to 0 to infinity k c r n minus k c r is equal to coefficient of x to the power n in expansion of 1 plus x whole raised to the power k into 1 plus x whole raised to the power n minus k, for which is equal to coefficient of x to the power n in 1 plus x whole raised to the power n. If we combine this two, so coefficient of x to the power n in 1 plus x whole raised to the power n is equal to n c n, because of expansion of 1 plus x whole raised to the power n is equal to 1 plus n c 1 x plus n c 2 x square plus n c r, or in case of n c r, x to the power r. So here, if coefficient of x to the power n in term of x 1 plus x whole raised to the power capital N is equal to n c capital N c n, and therefore expectation of x equal to 1 upon n c n, total summation over x equal to 0 to infinity of probability in this case n c n, n c cancel by this is equal to 1, and therefore the assignment of probabilities is permissible in this case, because total probability equal to 1 and probability always greater than or equal to 0 for every value of x. Now, mean and variance of geometric hypergeometric distribution. Mean of any discrete random variable represented by summation x vary from 0 to infinity x into probability mass function for x, and x equal to 0 to infinity x as it is, probability of x kcr n minus k c n minus r divided by n c n k c x, in this case n minus x. Now, 1 upon n c n is common, summation varying from 0 to infinity x. Now, kcx converge into k minus 1 factorial in the numerator, factorial k converge into k into k minus 1 factorial, and x factorial x into x minus 1 factorial, and n minus x, sorry, k minus x factorial as it is, n minus k c n minus x as it is. So, in this case, n c n as it is, summation varying from x equal to 0 to infinity, x cancel by x, k outside the summation notation, and k minus 1 factorial upon x minus 1 factorial k will represent k minus 1 c n minus 1
and n minus k c n minus x as it is, in this case x minus 1 solution, in this case x minus 1. So k upon n c n and the summation represent coefficient of x to the power n minus 1. This part represent coefficient of x to the power n minus 1 in expansion of 1 plus x whole raised to the power or y. 1 plus y whole raised to the power x, x a minus 1 and 1 plus y raised to the power n minus k, which is equal to coefficient of y to the power n minus 1 in expansion of 1 plus y, k can separate a capital n minus 1, and which is equal to n minus 1 c n minus 1. So in this case we get summation over from x equal to 0 to infinity k minus 1 c x minus 1 n minus k c n minus x is equal to n minus 1 c n minus 1, capital N minus 1 c n. So we get k upon n c n and n minus 1 c n minus 1. If we simplify this or convert into that form, so we get k n by n comma, we get n minus 1 c n minus 1 in denominator, and in numerator n minus 1 c n minus 1 c is cancelled by denominator values, and we get n k upon n, which is equal to expectation of x or mean of the hypergeometric distribution. And if n by n represent, k by n represent proportion of success in this case, then we get n into p. And similarly we can find variance of x equal to nk into n minus k n n minus 1 upon n square into n minus 1. So all these distributions related to a discrete random variable, so known as theoretical discrete probability distributions.